In this video, we're going to take a look at the Undercoat feature, which is part of the WIDTHSCRIBE panel in WIDTHSCRIBE2 by Astute Graphics. All right, so here we are again with some basic artwork. I'm just going to select this, and I'm going to create a basic WIDTHSCRIBE using a preset. All right, now you see my artwork is actually made up of several different strokes with a bunch of width markers to get this effect. All the white you're seeing here is actually the paper or the artboard behind my WIDTHSCRIBE. That means if I were to bring in another shape, like this guy here, now this guy is behind my WIDTHSCRIBE in the stacking order. So when I release, you're still able to see that object behind my WIDTHSCRIBE. All right, so that's where the undercoat feature comes in. What you want to do is select your stamp, come back over here to the WIDTHSCRIBE panel, and choose all settings. When I click on that, that's going to bring up my WIDTHSCRIBE settings. I'm going to make sure that my preview is turned on. And over here in the bottom left section, you're going to find use undercoat. Just click on this box and you've activated the undercoat. Now we have an opaque white and you're no longer seeing that shape behind it. All right, back over here in the window, you have this little color square. If you click on it, that's going to bring up your color picker. Now you can choose whatever color you want in here, but I'm going to go into my color swatches and scroll all the way to the bottom because this is the blue that I'd like to use. I'll click on it once and then click OK to accept. Now you can see that my artwork has already been updated and you cannot see the shape behind it. And there you have it, folks. That's the undercoat feature, which is part of the WIDTHSCRIBE panel in WIDTHSCRIBE 2 by Astute Graphics.